We were kids in a soul band. We were like 16, the drummer was 14 at the time, and we'd gone from being like a little mod soul band into this pop, soul, pin on the wall poster band. I mean, a load of people used to come down to our rehearsals. They came in one day with Everlasting Love because they were managers at Decca Records. And they came in with Everlasting Love on a Monument label by Robert Knight, Southern Soul singer. They put this record on and I just was completely, we got to do that. So we went in the studios with Muff Winwood in Island Studios, the band. So I turn up, back door Theobald's Road, and walk in the studio, and there's a 40-piece orchestra. And I'm like 17, so it's just the producer. What do you want me to do then? He said, get in that box and pretend to sing, but just make it up as you go along. Because you had a thing called a Musicians Union, which still goes today. And the rules were you had to sing live to the track. So I'm going, oh baby, I love you, and all this sort of rubbish. And then finished that, and then said, right, okay, now you've got to do the vocal for real. He went on, the fellow went on. Right, now you've got to do the vocal for real. So I went in the booth, and he gave me a brandy, and I never had a brandy in it. Two takes, it was done. And I just heard it on playback, like in here. I heard it on playback and I just thought, we've got something special.